Hello everyone, this is Teacher Juvie and I will be your guide for today's lesson.
Let us discuss division of whole numbers and decimal numbers. What is decimal? The word decimal comes from the Latin word decimal, meaning tenth part. Although we are using different notation, we are still considering the non-negative rational numbers. Division of decimals, just like multiplication, can be done using either the fraction method or the decimal method. So for this lesson, we will discuss the steps on how to divide whole numbers by a decimal number. Okay, so for example, ang ating i-divide ay 49 by 7 tenths. So as you can see, ang ating divisor ay isang decimal number. So ano ba yung dapat nating gawin kung ang whole number ay i-divide natin sa isang decimal number? So ang ating first step is, we always make the divisor a whole number. Since it is one decimal place, multiply the divisor to 10, at the same time, multiply the dividend by 10. So, dahil ang ating divisor ay isang decimal number nga, gagawin muna natin siyang whole number. So, paano natin magagawang whole number ang ating divisor? So, meron tayong dalawang paraan, pero yung unang paraan muna yung ang ituturo ko sa inyo. So, yung first way natin is we have to multiply the divisor by 10. Since ang ating decimal number or decimal place ay isa lamang. So, i-divide na, i-multiply natin siya by 10. Kung ano yung ginawa natin sa ating divisor, yun din yung ating gagawin sa ating dividend. So, we also have to multiply our dividend by 10. Okay, so, ganito ang kanyang kalalabasan. So, we have 49 divided by 7 tenths. So, gagawin nating whole number ang ating divisor by multiplying 10. So, 7 tenths multiplied by 10, so we will get 7. And kung ano yung ginawa natin sa ating divisor, yun din yung gagawin natin sa ating dividend. So, we will also multiply our dividend by 10. So, 49 times 10 will become 490. So, ang atin na ngayong i-divide is yung 490 by 7. Okay, so dahil na-convert na natin ang ating divisor sa whole number by multiplying the divisor by 10 and also the dividend by 10, so pwede na tayong mag-proceed on dividing whole numbers. So, ang 4 ay hindi pwedeng i-divide sa 7, so kukunin natin yung another digit na 9, so magiging 49, and 49 is divisible by 7, so we will get 7. 7 times 7 is 49. Then, subtract the two numbers. So, we will get 0. Then, 0, i-divide natin sa 7. That is 0. Okay, therefore, ang ating nakuhang quotient when we divide 49 by 7 tenths is 70. Okay, so, para malaman natin kung tama ba ang ating nakuhang sagot, siyempre, gagamitin natin or gagawin natin ang step 3, which is checking. So, sa pag-check, imumultiply lamang natin yung ating nakuhang quotient na 70 sa ating divisor na 7 tenths. So, 70 multiplied by 7 tenths. So, we will get 490, and we will put the decimal point sa pagitan ng 9 and 0. Dahil, pag binilang natin yung mga decimal places, isa lamang yung kanyang decimal places. So, ilagay natin yung decimal point sa pagitan ng 9 and 0. So, therefore, tama ang ating kasagutan na when we divide 49 by 7 tenths, so we will get 70.
Let's try more examples. So, find the quotient of 208 and 8 tenths. So, again, ang una natin gagawin is we will have to change our divisor sa whole number by multiplying the divisor by 10. And kung ano yung ginawa natin sa ating divisor, nag-multiply tayo ng 10, yun din yung ating gagawin sa ating dividend. We will also multiply it by 10. So, ang kalalabasan ngayon, yung 8 tenths natin ay magiging 8 na lamang. And yung ating dividend ay magiging 2,080. Diba? Pag binultiply natin ang 208 by 10, we will get 2,080. Then, proceed na tayo sa division ng whole number. Dahil whole number na yung ating nakuha. So, 20 divided by 8, so we will get 2. Then, multiply 2 times 8, so we will get 16. Then, subtract the numbers. So, 20 minus 16 is 4. So, 4 is not divisible by 8. So, ibibring down natin yung 8. 48 divided by 8, that is 6. Then, multiply 6 times 8. So, we will get 48. Then, subtract the numbers. So, we will get 0. Then, ibring down na lang natin yung 0. So, hindi tayo pwedeng mag-stop pa dito. Dahil meron pa tayong space dito sa dulo. So, i-divide natin yung 0 by 8. 0 divided by 8 is 0 and 0 times 8 is 0. Then, subtract the numbers, we will get 0. Therefore, when we divide 208 by 8 tenths, the answer or the quotient is 260. Okay, so find the quotient of 355 and 5 tenths. So, dahil nga isang decimal place lang ang meron sa ating divisor, kaya i-multiply natin siya by 10. So, yung 5 tenths, gagawin muna nating whole number ang ating divisor. So, i-multiply natin sa 10. So, we will get 5. And yung ating dividend ay i-multiply din natin sa 10. So, we will get 3,550. Then we can now proceed on dividing the whole numbers. So 35 divided by 5, we will get 7. Then 7 times 5 is 35. Then subtract 35 minus 35. So that is 0. Then bring down 5. 5 divided by 5 is 1. And 1 times 5 is 5. Then subtract again. So we will get 0. So i-bring down na natin yung 0. Dahil 0 naman dito yung 5 minus 5. At hindi tayo pwedeng mag-stop dahil may space pa tayong natitira. So 0 i-divide mo sa 5. That is 0. 0 times 5 is 0. So subtract natin. So we will get 0. So ang ating quotient now is 710. Okay, so since you already know how to divide the whole number by a decimal number, so how about if the division done with decimals? Oh, how is division done with decimals? So how do we divide decimals or mixed decimals by decimals? These are the steps in order to divide mixed decimals by decimals. So kanina ang ating ginawa ay yung whole number, yung ating dividend, diba? Then yung kanyang divisor ay decimal number. So ngayon naman, pareho na silang decimal number. Yung ating dividend ay decimal and yung ating divisor ay decimal. So, we also follow the steps in dividing mixed decimals by decimals. Okay, example, we will divide 25 hundredths by 5 tenths. So, napapansin nyo, pareho na silang decimal number. So, ano yung ating first step? So, step 1, make the divisor a whole number by multiplying it by 10 or just move the decimal point 1 decimal place to the right to make the divisor a whole number. So, yun yung another way natin para magawa nating whole number ang ating divisor. So, pwede nating i-multiply by 10 or pwede namang i-move natin ng isang step to the right ang ating decimal point. So, any of the two, pwede nating gamitin. Okay, so gagawin na natin whole number ang ating divisor by multiplying the divisor with 10. So, 5 tenths times 10, so we will get 5. So, magiging whole number na, 5 na ang ating divisor. Then, tatandaan nyo lagi kung ano yung ginawa nyo sa divisor ay gagawin nyo rin yun sa ating dividend. So, yung 25 hundredths natin, imumultiply din natin siya by 10. So, ang mangyayari, ang 25 hundredths magiging 2 and 5 tenths na. Then, next naman, next step is, i-divide na natin siya just like the whole numbers. So, put the decimal point of the quotient just above the decimal point of the dividend. So, yung ating decimal point dito, ilalagay lang natin yan sa itaas. So, mamaya makikita nyo. Okay, so proceed tayo sa division. 2 i-divide natin sa 5, that is 0, diba? Wala naman tayong makuha ang 5 sa 2. Then, 0 i-multiply natin sa 5, we will get 0. Then subtract. 2 minus 0 is 2. So ayun, nilagay ko na yung decimal point sa katapat lang ng ating decimal point ng ating dividend. So 2, then bring down 5. 25 divide mo sa 5, we will get 5, then multiply 5 times 5, that is 25, then subtract, so we will get 0. So the quotient now is when we divide 25 hundredths by 5 tenths, we will get 5 tenths. Okay, another example. Divide 81 hundredths by 9 hundredths. So, napansin nyo yung ating divisor ay 2 decimal places na. So, in hundredths na yung kanyang places, di ba? So, anong gagawin natin? Dahil 2 decimal places na yung ating divisor, i-multiply naman natin siya by 100 na. So, yung 9 hundredths natin, mumultiply natin siya by 100. At ang kalalabasan niyan ay magiging 9. Para mga magiging whole number siya, di ba? Then, again, kung ano yung ginawa natin sa divisor, gagawin din natin sa ating dividend. So, yung 81 hundredths, gagawin natin, ay mumultiply natin by 100. So, ang makukuha natin dyan is 81. So, proceed na tayo sa pag-divide ng whole number. 81 divide by 9, that is 9. So, okay. So, the answer or the quotient now is 81 hundredths multiplied or divided by 9 hundredths. The answer is 9. Okay. So, mag-try pa tayo ng another example para ma-master natin ang pag-divide ng decimal number sa decimal number. So, let's divide 96 hundredths by 12 hundredths. Okay, so since ang ating divisor ay 2 decimal places, para magawa natin siyang whole number, kailangan natin siyang i-multiply by 100. So, yung 12 hundredths multiplied by 100, we will get 12. So, whole number na siya. Then, don't forget na kung ano yung ginawa nyo sa divisor ay gagawin nyo rin sa ating dividend. So, yung 96 hundredths, i-multiply din natin siya by 100. So, magiging 96 na siya. Then, proceed na tayo sa division. 96 divided by 12. So, we will get 8. So, 0. So, ang ating quotient now is when we divide 96 hundredths by 12 hundredths, the answer or the quotient is 8. Okay, next is we divide 63 hundredths by 21 hundredths. So, ang first step natin is we have to make our divisor a whole number by multiplying it to 100 dahil nga 2 decimal places siya. Then, 21 multiplied by 100, so we will get 21. And we will also multiply our dividend by 100, so we will get 63. Then, proceed on dividing the numbers. 63 divided by 21, we will get 3. 3 times 21 is 63. And 63 minus 63 is 0. Therefore, the quotient is when we divide 63 hundredths by 21 hundredths, the answer is 3. So, we have to remember that in dividing decimal or mixed decimal by decimals, we have to use the following steps. First, change the divisor to our whole number by moving the decimal point to the rightmost place or multiply it by 10 if only one decimal place or 100 if two decimal places. So, ang ginawa natin kanina is nag-multiply lang tayo doon sa ating divisor to make it a whole number. 10 kapag 1 decimal place at 100 naman kapag 2 decimal places. Second, move the decimal point in the dividend to as many places as the decimal point in the divisor is moved or multiply it also by 10 or 100. So, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina na kung ano yung ginawa nyo sa divisor, gagawin nyo rin sa ating dividend. And take note that what we do with the divisor, we do the same to the dividend. Then third, insert zeros to the dividend when needed. So let's apply what we have learned in solving the problem. In science class, Miss Alcalde had 30 6/10 pounds of igneous rock. She divided equally by weight into 9 different containers. How many pounds of rock will be in each container? So, hinahanap natin ngayon yung kung ilang pounds kada isang container. Okay, so let's show the solution. So we will divide 30 and 6 tenths by 9. So madali lang to dahil ang ating divisor ay already a whole number. So no need to change this to whole number. So proceed na tayo agad sa pag-divide ng decimal number to by a whole number naman. So 30 divided by 9 is 3. And 3 times 9 is 27. And subtract the numbers, you will get 3. So 3 is not divisible by 9. So kailangan nating i-bring down ng 6. So we will get 36. And yung ating decimal point ay i-align lang natin doon sa decimal point ng ating dividend. Okay? So 36 divided by 9 is 4. And 4 times 9 is 36. So we will get 0. So the quotient now is 3 and 4 tenths. Therefore, 3 and 4 tenths pounds of rocks will be in each container. So, yung kada isang container, naglalaman ito ng 3 and 4 tenths pounds of rocks. Okay, another problem. A fisherman caught 15 and 45 hundredths kilograms of fish. He distributed the fish equally among his 5 family members. How many kilograms did each family member get? Okay, so ngayon naman, ang total number ng o total kilograms na nakuha ng fisherman is 15 and 45 kilograms ng fish. So, dinistribute niya yon sa kanyang 5 miyembro ng pamilya. So, kada isang miyembro, ilang kilogram ng fish ang kanilang nakuha. Okay, so here's the solution. We will divide 15 and 45 hundredths by 5. So, kung napapansin nyo, ang ating divisor is already a whole number. So, no need to change this to whole number. So, proceed tayo sa pag-divide. 15 divided by 5 is 3 and 3 times 5 is 15. Then, ilagay natin ang decimal point sa naka-align lang siya sa decimal point ng ating dividend. So, 15 minus 15 is 0. So, bring down 4. And mag-bring down lang tayo 1 at a time. Hindi natin agad pwedeng pababain yung 5 or i-bring down yung 5. So, kailangan muna nating i-divide ang 4 sa 5. And wala naman tayo makukuha ang 5 sa 4. Therefore, ang ating quotient is 0. So, 0 times 5 is 0. Then, saka tayo mag-subtract. So, 4. Then, saka natin ibaba or i-bring down yung 5. 45. So, 45 divided by 5, so we will get 9, and 9 times 5 is 45. Then, subtract the numbers, we will get 0. Therefore, ang ating nakuhang quotient is 3 and 9 hundredths. So, the answer to the problem is 3 and 9 hundredths kilograms of fish ang na-receive ng kanyang family member. Next. Mary would like to pour 3 and 5 tenths liters of fresh milk equally into 7 bottles. How many liters of fresh milk each does bottle contain? So, ilan yung litro ng fresh milk yung kada isang bote or nilalaman ng isang bote? Okay, so the solution is 3 and 5 tenths divided by 7. So, again, ang ating divisor is already a whole number. So, proceed on division. 3 divided by 7 is 0. Then, 0 times 7 is 0. So, subtract natin. We will get 3. And, ilagay muna natin ang ating decimal point doon sa, or nakatapat sa decimal point ng ating dividend. So, subtract ulit tayo. 3 minus 0 is 3. Then, bring down 5. 35 divided by 7 is 5, and 5 times 7 is 35. Then subtract 35 minus 35 is 0. So the answer now is 5 tenths liters of fresh milk each test bottle contains. So yung kada isang bote, ang laman niya is 5 tenths liters of fresh milk.
Thanks for watching this video. Hit like if you learned from this video and don't forget to subscribe on my channel. Thank you so much.